I have messages from two friends of Wayne, Wayne Green and Dexter Layton. Wayne Green was a writer with the Miami Herald for years and also a resident of Friends of the Everglades, who I also represented. And their message is short with me. Juanita says, "Wayne was an important warrior in the battle to protect the foreign environment." She meant that she and Wayne kind of were close and involved in some litigation that we did for a number of years. Dexter Layton was a former U.S. attorney for Southern Florida. He could not be here today because he's with his wife, Leanna Ross Layton, who is the congresswoman from Miami-Dade, and they're in Korea at present, hopefully resolving all the problems over there. His message, similar, was, "I always appreciated his commitment to the cause and his willingness to keep fighting, even when things were bleak." Those are accurate statements. The last few years have been really hard for me. I met with him about 6 months ago. Every step he took, every breath he took, was tough for him. He has earned the peace that he has found. When Jim Carter called me to tell me the news last week about me, I started thinking of all the years, all the issues, all the people we worked with, and him, we sing in our church, came to mind. The refrain was like this: "You're called to act with justice. You're called to love tenderly. You're called to serve one another, to walk humbly with God." Now, Wayne was not someone who describes humble. But when he was on the lake, I know he felt that way. I know he felt the presence of God, and that what peace there was for him on this earth was the peace he found on the lake. So when Lake Okeechobee was experiencing huge algae blooms in the mid-1980s, he wanted to take some action. He asked me to come down from Pennsylvania to help find a way to stop the backbumping discharges from sugarcane fields in the Lake Okeechobee. When I got down here, Wayne introduced me to a bunch of people who knew a lot about the problem, including Scott Driver, one of the leaders of the coalition of groups that started FADE, Jim Harvey, then with the South Florida Water Management District, Herb Zivas, then with Florida DEP, and a fellow named Joe Cotton, who was with Friends of the Everglades at the time. My idea was to bring the backcountry discharges under the federal NPDES permit program. Florida was one of the few states who had not requested to become delegated by EPA to implement the Clean Water Act NPDES permit program. Herb Zivas, when he was with Florida DEP, he was their representative for the lake, had been trying for years to get the two Niagara districts under state discharge permits. But Herb was repeatedly frustrated by delays and obfuscations by the Water Management District entities. As Herb said, enforcing laws and regulations should be a simple, straightforward line. But with politics in the picture, that line can become quite curvy and obscure. Wayne and I agreed on focusing on an entity called Kloster Farms, which is the only privately owned 298 district, water management district, under the control of Florida Crystals and Alphonse Von Kuhl. We filed our complaint against Kloster in federal court in 1989. The case was under Judge Rucker here in West Palm Beach, who was the president judge of the Southern District of the federal court system. And under him, our case dragged on for more than 10 years. Wayne and I had no money, no staff or volunteers, no administrative help. And we didn't have one major resource, obtaining testimony, Bert was able to make the scientific case for us before the board. In the end, however, we lost on a technical issue before the 11th Circuit Court of Appeals. In the meantime, in 1993, I began working with friends of the Everglades on water quality issues, along with the Mississippi Tribe of Indians. We brought a suit against the backcountry discharge from Broward County into northern Everglades. We were successful there in both the District Court and the 11th Circuit. As a result, I took a second stab at the backcountry discharges into the lake, this time on behalf of both Fred Fade and Friends of the Everglades. We filed against two major pumping stations on the southern end of the lake, the S2 and the S3. They were pumping water back into the lake from the three major canals that drain the sugar fields in the Everglades agricultural area. This time, we were not alone. We were joined by the Florida Wildlife Federation, represented by Earth Justice, and again by the tribes in a meeting. The Water Management District was the defendant. They were joined by the State of Florida, DEP, by the EPA, by the Corps of Engineers, by the Justice Department, and by several major sugar growers. After years of preparation for trial, we went to trial before Judge Altanaga in Miami. The trial lasted more than 2 months, and verdict in our favor. Frankly, I believe the testimony of people, both volunteers for Fade and Friends of the Everglades, are received. And I knew Paul Gray, who was the, and still is, the Audubon scientist for Lake Okeechobee, we were successful. But again, several years on appeal to the 11th Circuit, we were overturned by the 11th Circuit again on technicality. That technicality is still under appeal. This work that Wayne got us into has taken almost a quarter of a century. A lot has been learned by all sides of the dispute. And the EPA and the NPDES permit program are now part of the process. Working with Wayne all these years is based on a well-defined relationship. When the conversation was about the Clean Water Act and the development of our case, I talked and Wayne listened. The other 90% of the time, he talked and I listened. All of us here today to celebrate Wayne's life know that he was not an easy person to meet with. It wasn't easy for him either. He was uncompromising with both himself and everyone else. He had high standards for integrity and a strong sense of justice. I honor this man, and I honor our friendship. And whenever I hear that hymn still running through my head, which goes, "We are called to act with justice. We are called to love tenderly. We are called to serve one another."